Boys and girls, welcome to another edition of MR2 Spyder for Dummies. This means you. Just kidding. The vehicle we're looking at right now is not an MR2 Spyder. It is a Toyota Matrix with a 2zz engine, and you can recognize the characteristic intake manifold of the 2zz right here. But what I am going to show you today does apply to this vehicle and to any Toyota MR2 Spyder, whether it is a 1zz or a 2zz. What I'm going to show you is how to perform the most basic diagnostics on your engine to determine how well is it running correctly, and if not, is there something wrong with it. So let's go ahead. The tools that I am using for this episode are Torque Pro. This is an Android app that you can load on any Android phone or tablet. Here I'm using a tablet because I like it a lot better than a phone for this purpose. And you can get this app from the Play Store for $5. Think you can splurge for that? I think you should. The other tool that I am using is this OBD2 adapter from OBD-Link. This is the LX model. And this is a little bit pricey, it's $50, but it gives a very high data rate. It can give a data rate of more than 50 samples per second when connected to your engine's computer. And this can make a difference when you want to look at the performance of your engine. To get started, I've plugged the OBD link into the DLC data link connector, or the OBD2 port of the car, which is, surprise surprise, right under the dash. Next, I let the Torque app pair itself with the OBD2 adapter. And you can see from the top left-hand corner where you see a little picture of the car that we are now paired and connected. So this tablet is communicating directly with the ECU. So now I'm going to switch to tablet mode. We are now recording exactly what you would see on the tablet. And we're looking at Torque Pro. And what I want to go into is the real-time information or live data, and we can get to that by clicking right here on the icon that says real-time information. I clicked on real-time info and I've gone straight to the screen that I have set up for monitoring this car. So the three most important things that I want to look at, starting on the top row, I have the O2 sensor, bank one, sensor one. Okay, I have the O2 sensor underneath it, bank two, sensor one. This does not exist on this car, but it does exist on your MR2 Spyder. So this will remain blank for now. If it were here, you would see it activated, and you'll see what it shows in a minute. And then right underneath that is the downstream O2 sensor, bank one, sensor two. That's the sensor that is after the catalytic converter, and it's used for monitoring the emissions. There you see right next to O2 sensor, bank one, sensor two, there's a little indicator for the fuel status. This tells us whether we are in open loop or closed loop. Right next to it, we have the coolant temperature, the intake temperature, the volts from the battery or the alternator. Then in the corner, there's the RPM counter. Above it is the Maf sensor. And then I have a few more sensors up high. There's the throttle, the timing advance from the ECU, the speed, and the load. The load is equivalent to the filling percentage. of the cylinders or the volumetric efficiency. This is also sent by the ECU. So we have not started the car yet. Let's go ahead and start it and we'll look at what happens. Okay, the car is now running, and in a moment we will see these indicators starting to refresh. Okay, so there we go. The O2 sensor has just started to refresh. We see that its voltage is now changing, and as the voltage changes, the fuel trims start to change. As soon as we go into a closed loop, which if you are paying attention, you saw that the fuel status changed from open loop to closed loop, and when that happened, then the O2 sensor began to function and the fuel trims began to change. Okay, so now you see how the O2 sensor, the primary O2 sensor, functions. It oscillates constantly. That means it goes up and down and up and down, and it ranges between the low value of about 0.1, which corresponds, 0.1 volts corresponds to a lean condition, and it goes up to a high value that could be as high as about 0.9 volts, and this corresponds to a rich condition. Now the lean and rich are right around stoichiometric, so what the ECU is doing is just testing the with the O2 sensor to see if it is maintaining in the neighborhood of a stoichiometric air fuel ratio. All right, and so you can see that going on with the O2 sensor on bank 1 sensor 1, and we can see that on this car the ECU, by looking at the short-term fuel trim, we can see that the ECU has determined that it needs to remove a little bit of fuel. That's why it has a slightly negative short-term fuel trim. And after it continues with this short-term fuel trim, this negative short-term fuel trim, for a while, that will be reflected in the long-term fuel trim, which is now zero, but will take a time averaged value that is derived from the short-term fuel trim. Okay, and this is all normal. We have just started up this car following a battery disconnect, so everything was cleared, and we're starting from scratch. So while the fuel trims level out, let's take a quick tour of the other sensors. You can see that our coolant temperature is slowly increasing. It's at 140 degrees Fahrenheit now, but it just went up 1.8 degrees, and the intake temperature is also going to increase because the car is just stationary and the engine bay is heating up. Our volts from the alternator are steady. Our revs are maybe a little bit higher than we would like. We're idling at about 1,000 right now, but it's coming, it should be coming down. The Maf sensor is reading normal, which is about 3.5 grams per second at an idle of about 1,000. And You know, and at this ambient temperature which we have right now, this is a normal mass airflow reading. Usually you would look between 3 and 5 grams per second. And the timing advance above that you see is at about 15 degrees, which is also normal. And the load on the engine, the percentage of filling of the cylinders, is just about 20%, which is also normal. Okay, so now you can see, if you look back at the O2 sensor, that it is going into the normal range, more like the normal range, where it ranges between 0.1 and 0.9 and back. All right, and the fuel trim, short-term fuel trim, is continuing to pull fuel, and soon enough, if we were to continue this video for long enough, we would see the long-term fuel trim value dropping from zero to a small negative value, and then the short-term fuel trim would equilibrate. Okay, and at this point we're also seeing that the catalytic converter has heated up, and the rear O2 sensor is starting to function normally. It functions with a delay and a little bit damped from the primary O2 sensor, and this is normal. All right, and once this heats up nicely, then it will range a little bit wider. Okay, so as I've said, we do not have a bank 2 sensor, so the O2 sensor for bank 2, sensor 1 is just staying completely flat because it does not even exist. So this pretty much completes what I wanted you to see about using this tool for checking the status and the function of your engine and its running condition, especially with paying close attention to the O2 sensor voltages and the fuel trims. And you can see now that the long-term fuel trim has in fact taken a step down, just as I predicted, as a result of the short-term fuel trims averaged over time. And as the idle has dropped a little bit lower, the mass airflow rate has also dropped, because this depends on the amount of air being, the quantity of air being drawn into the engine, and this depends on the RPM. All right, so I think we've seen some pretty interesting things here. Look at how the long-term fuel trim has dropped, and the short-term fuel trim is re-equilibrating towards zero. And this is just a pretty interesting demonstration of how long-term fuel trims and short-term fuel trims work together hand in hand. You just saw it here first. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and come back again for another fun and interesting episode of MR2 Spyder for Dummies.